Hey guys, AJ here, back with another one for you. So for all you guys that have been following me for a long time, you guys know that one of the things that I talk about a lot on this channel are these female teachers abusing young students, okay? And how nobody talks about this. It happens all the time. It's like every day there's a new case that this happens, right? And no one cares. And when these teachers do get caught, they get a slap on the wrist. So guys, I just did a video about Jacqueline Ma. And she's a San Diego teacher who was Teacher of the Year. And she got arrested for essay of a young boy, one of her young male students. Well guys, she has some new charges because a second student came forward and now she's in more hot water. So guys, we're going to get into this. But before we do, you guys like, subscribe, drop a comment. It really helps keep this channel going, guys. If you have a TCAP request, put it in the comments, guys. Join the Discord. I drop the link during the lives, or I will drop the link to anyone who wants it in the comments, guys. And join the lives Tuesdays and Friday evenings. So, yeah, guys, let's just get a refresher of who Jacqueline Ma is. So this is her.
I don't think anyone can discount that these past few.
This is before she got arrested, okay?
One of those California Teacher of the Year program, and one of those teachers, Jacqueline Ma from Lincoln Acres Elementary School, joins us now to talk more about being one of those chosen five. Good morning, Miss Ma. How are you?
Good morning. I am doing well. Thank you so much for having me this morning.
Absolutely. Congratulations again on the honor. What did it mean to you to be selected?
It still feels a little surreal.
So this is right when she got the Teacher of the Year award, okay? And she talks about how much she cares about her students, blah, 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 right? And guys, this is her first court appearance.
San Diego Elementary School teacher, formerly named Teacher of the Year, made another appearance in court this morning in Chula Vista, accused of an inappropriate relationship with a former student.
34-year-old Jacqueline Ma remains in custody without bail after being arrested twice. She faces felony charges, and during this morning's readiness conference, Ma's attorneys and the court agreed to push her preliminary hearing until August. So her next appearance is slated for July 26. She faces nearly 30 years in prison.
30 years in prison. Guys, let me know if you actually think that she's gonna get anywhere near that much time. Crazy.
If she's convicted.
All right, guys, here we have one more report here. This is when she had, here we go.
Just a few hours ago, Jacqueline Ma, the award-winning National City sixth grade teacher accused of having a sexual relationship with a former student, answered to those charges for the first time in a Chula Vista courtroom. CBS 8's Brian White was there at Ma's arraignment. Brian, what did we learn today?
Yeah, parents at Lincoln Acres Elementary were shocked, to say the least, by the allegations of sexual misconduct with a former student by Jacqueline Ma, someone who had recently been honored with the prestigious Teacher of the Year Award. I was there when she appeared in court.
Ms. Ma, good afternoon. Can you hear me, ma'am?
Yes, Your Honor, I can hear you.
34-year-old Jackie Ma pled not guilty while appearing over...
Of course she did. Do you guys actually think that she would come... that she would actually confess? You know what I'm saying? And actually just own up to what she did? Of course not, right guys?
Video in court today. She's facing 15 felony counts of sexual misconduct with 15. A minor under 14 years old, including lewd and lascivious acts.
This defendant?
There's a charge, guys. Lewd, lascivious acts. Just like all the knuckleheads from TCAP get, right?
Was obsessive, possessive, controlling, and dangerous.
Look at that. Obsessive, controlling, and dangerous, they call her behavior.
I was first arrested last Tuesday after a parent suspected her 13-year-old child of having an inappropriate relationship with her. She soon bailed out, but National City Police arrested her again Thursday on additional felony counts of sexual misconduct, a witness intimidation charge, and multiple counts related to child pornography.
A witness intimidation charge and child porn. Absolute clown world, man. That, guys, and there's going to be people out there saying, I can't believe that a woman would do this. I can't believe it. How can a woman do? Guys, I say this all the time. there's a small percentage of every group, male, female, man, woman, black, white, Hispanic, you know, gay, straight, you know, LGBTQ, Christian, Muslim, or whatever, that are pieces of trash. A small group of each of those groups. And the majority of people, guys, are good people, okay? There's a small group of those people, of each of those groups of people that are not good people. Do not ever let a label cloud your judgment when it comes to being cautious around people, okay?
When she was arrested, she had a photograph of the victim in her wallet. She had jewelry with his initials. Love letters were discovered in her classroom, directed at the child.
Ma is being held at the Las Colinas Women's Detention Facility on no bail, something her attorney challenged in court.
She owns and lives in Chula Vista. She's been living there since 2016 when she purchased her first home with her husband. So a flight risk.
Oh, she's married too. I forgot. I don't think she has any kids though. But she's married too, guys. I wonder what her husband thinks.
It's no flight risk whatsoever.
Arguing for no bail, Deputy District Attorney Drew Hart described the inappropriate relationship between Ma and the then 12-year-old child.
12 years old, guys. Guys, I know that I usually keep these videos lighthearted, but this is the one thing. We laugh at the TCAP Redditors, ha ha ha, okay? And some of the true crime stuff, we have to laugh to keep from crying, right? But guys, this is not funny, okay? All these young male victims, no one cares about them, no one. Just listen to the language that's being used to describe. They always try and make female predators out to be the victims when they are the victimizers, guys. Absolute clown world.
He said it all began in late December.
At one point when the child was 12 years old, she got him in a position where he was alone in her classroom and started making advances. This victim did not know what to do and reported that it felt surreal.
He went on to describe some of the communications when the victim was no longer a student of hers.
In these messages, the defendant was persistent in sending illicit photographs of herself to the victim and then soliciting the victim to do the same. She would persistently directed him to engage in sex acts while he was at home and to video record them.
The what? Judge denied bail and any pretrial release. If
I must have missed that part the last time that I reviewed this.
Convicted on all charges, Ma could face 29 years in state prison. She's set to appear in court on March 16th for a bail review hearing.
Guys, put in the comments, what do you think would make someone do this? Like, what do you think is wrong with this woman? You know what I'm saying? Seriously. And guys, let's just get to her newest charges. And I went over this on a live stream. Look at this, guys. Former Teacher of the Year faces new charges involving second minor. A former National City Teacher of the Year is facing new charges of misconduct involving a second minor. An amended complaint filed this week by San Diego County, let me get rid of that. A DA accuses Jacqueline Ma of committing a lewd act with a student who's under the age of 14. Ma, who's being held without bail, was first arrested in March. She now faces 19 total charges. That is crazy. Guys. Let me know. You guys think? I mean, guys, put in the comments, how much time do you think that they're going to get? First of all, out of these 19 charge guys, I want you to speculate. How many of these do you think that she's going to be convicted of? Okay? Because I don't think she'll get even half, honestly. Because that's just not how the system works. Okay? There's no real justice for a lot of young, you know, male victims of these types of crimes. And that has to change, guys. It has to. I know, guys, that I should be laughing, having fun. This is not funny, okay? It's not. And there's all these knuckleheads, all these guys in the, you know, that little boy should be lucky. No. No children should be having, you know, those types of relationships or engaging in that type of behavior, okay? Science and studies show that minors, any type of this done, it damages the minds and the development of young boys and girls. Okay? So anyone that would ever say, I think it's great. You know, I don't know why everyone's mad at a 12-year-old boy with a 32-year-old woman. No, that's not how it works. Absolute clown world, guys. People should be ashamed of themselves. I think there was one more article, guys. Let me see if I can pull this up here. Wait, this is the last one. Look at this. Here it is. New charges. Look at that. This is her. Look at that. John Doe 2. Indicate the boy was under 14 years old at the time. And the offenses occurred in early 2020. They haven't yet commented on whether the victim was also a formal student. But they do say that it happened in the classroom. She now faces over 150 years to life in state prison if convicted on 19 felony counts. So guys, yeah, please. Let me know what you think she'll get. And the amount of charges that you think she'll be found guilty of, and the amount of time. Because I don't think it'll be much, guys. Okay? Ma was arrested in March, so we all know that. Yeah, guys. And they actually took her off the Teacher of the Year site. So, all right, you guys, this is AJ. I will keep you guys updated on this. You know, sorry it wasn't a funny one today. But, guys, like, subscribe, join the Discord, guys. We're almost at 1,000 subs. And then, you know, Jeff's local pizza party. So, all right, you guys, I appreciate you guys. Have a good one.